Hey everyone, it's Mirri's Reaper, and today I've got a bit of a video. Yes, it's a dungeon video, but it's not a solo dungeon per se. Why? There's companions now. So this dungeon is a semi-solo with companions, with Mirri. Mirri is a dark elf companion that came with Blackwood on the 1st of June for PC, the 8th of June for console. I got it on the 8th of June due to the idea that I play on Xbox. But yeah, I took her through Wayrest Sewers. Just for some gear, just for some XP, you know, get her leveled up a bit. But yeah, this is the outcome of that one. Yay. So, Wayrest Sewers 1. Where is this, you ask? It's in Wayrest. Stormhaven. Okay, quite literally in the middle of the town. City, whatever you want to call it. So, let's get this done. Shall we? Now, first batch of mobs. Right. So of course I'm going to be with companions. This came out on the 8th. Can't really say it's a solo run because, well, you know, companions, it's another person.
Yeah. You know, I like to think I'm agreeable.
Which is completely fine. I'm not sure if you'll be able to hear Mirri speaking, commenting on everything we do together. So in this dungeon you will also see that there are some fishing holes. So, one moment, I have a crocodile after me. So these things here, these sprouty little bits of water, those are fishing holes. You'll see quite a few of those, and Mirri, why are you attacking crocodiles? Okay, there's no need to do that, okay? Mirri seems to have a good idea of crocodiles. She never told me that. And goblins. And you're killing people. Yeah, I don't need to be touched with the crocodiles that are in there. Just while running their point, let's like drop into there. You know? This is also. Mirri, are you done? Mirri? Mirri, stop it. Mirri. Enough, Mirri. Yeah, these past few days, ever since I got Mirri, it's been like a lot of Mirri, why are you doing this? Just Mirri, get out my way. Good job, Mirri. I mean, he's just I'm gonna stay out of the way. I'm not really sure about Bastion, as I've not really progressed with him besides getting the ability to have him, I guess, with the quest in Blackwood. If I am doing a video about getting one saving myself for purples, because as soon as you put them on, they are bound.
You're not leaving here alive.
And I'll probably save, say, medium armor for us.
Heal me!
We've got two of those. Using too much magicka, like let it fucking regain. And one time I ran out of stamina because I'd been running, and she's like, drink a stamina potion, you will get some green doctor thing, whatever you call it, for making a alcohol beverage every 5 minutes. I actually think the raptor is not on a timeline. One day I took her to go to Public City to do a daily. And she's like, oh my god, I so busy, I'll have this place. And I'm like, yep. Look, this is so beautiful, maybe I can research it. I took her to go see Vivek. She had nothing to say about that. Fighters Guild, she loves when you hand those in with her. Bastion, it is the Mages Guild. Right, let me just gain up all this. So with this one, he'll basically teleport around here, summoning a bunch of like ghosts. There'll be this little AoE that follows you around. Try not to get into it. Okay?
Have you come to meddle as well?
You see, he's just there. He's gonna start throwing stuff and he's teleporting. This file, dodge that, and here is a little AoE that I was referring to. Like basically you stay out of Mirri died. I went to see how we would deal with it. But you know, I always record, well, I go into it first and then I record afterwards. And I went into here yesterday. Just to see how we would fathom. So I can know the mechanics again. He'll teleport soon. And he will summon in
those interlopers.
So the metal souls, which will basically race. I've never heard of it in it long enough to know what it does, like, damage you. But yeah. Try and get these Breath of Souls out of here. Okay, yes, he was going to win, but it's less things to worry about. Besides, A of the Circle, death. His does it. is still before. So, now that, you know, we're supposed to be dead, I don't pay attention to that circle. So, as you see, I'm doing a solo, so anything that I don't have in the sticker book is instantly put into my sticker book. That I've already got, it just continues to shine. So more skeevers, and over there is the next boss. This is where Mirri died, in fact. For the boss, he got me. I believe there is something through here. Last time I was in there, because I was just doing a sledge. Didn't matter, so we'll do that afterwards. Right now we shall go over here. I'll probably show you where we are on the map. So here is this boss, then there's this pit that in Wayrest 2 there is a boss. But here there's a bunch of skeevers, vermin skeevers. Crocodile. Not close to that over there. There's a boss. But now that we've done this, we're in here. We're going to otherwise, we're going to go. Yeah, it's a side boss. So I don't know what the purpose is of this, but. Something else, best to check over there. Before I go off and do this boss, I will be. Nope, it's a bunch of rats, because his name is the Rat Whisperer. So before I go and do this, I shall get the rest of these ads.
More food for my liver one.
Just so, you know, if I roll away, I don't want them and aggro them. Back up just a bit. So basically he's got the same health as the crocodile, slime crawl, or whatever his name was. Okay, as you can kind of see as well, I've got the new trial to do. Okay, so I'd say that this is enough. Let's get that up. I was thinking things were too easy today. Too easy. That's a new line from you.
Come to me, my
so yeah, he's gonna fall off a bunch of skeevers, which are basically the Pied Piper. Just try and burn. Because, well, you know, there's going to be a lot of these skeevers coming up. I actually am going to die, probably. No, I'm not, because I'm going to die. So, yeah, he's going to keep on spawning a bunch of these. And when I know what the perfect thing is for it, get out of the way. Yeah, you can see a lot of skeevers when you're not. Yeah. Alright, get out of the way. Yep, I just died. Proof that I'm not all that great. Come on. So Mirri looked like she died as well. Which is great. Mirri. You meant to help me, girl. You meant to help me out with this. The first one just because yeah, but because the thing that screwed me over just then was the controller dying. That's what screwed me over big time.
First those nobles and now you threaten them. You don't belong here. Oh.
Mirri is back alive. Oof. Okay, so shall we kill these crocodiles that are over here? And skeevers. Especially you.
Mirri, you do need to
just
don't you? Well, next time I do that, that boss is going to be questionable. Okay. So the boss is up there. Urgalg the Hungry. Okay. So what we do is we try and get all of these axes gone. Okay. Little bits at a time. You know, try not to grab the attention of the boss. Very hard on a magic tune, so it's here it comes right now. When I first did this, he just came down to Afterlife and all the ads. What changed? I didn't hit you. Which is fine. Yes, you are very I'll update you all. No, Mirri, no. Mirri is down. Okay. So I cannot haunt him, which is a pain for them. Yeah, Mirri did not last long with this guy. But the age is a half of 3 people at a time. So we survived on the last one, which is odd to say. And yes, you can res them, but if I res right now, I would be in a heartbeat, even though I have the reduces the time for which it takes for me to res, it still doesn't work out in my favour. Most of the time. Sometimes it does, but that's when I have a tank to help out. Yes guys, the reason why she dies a lot is because I don't have her armor set up yet. You gotta think, Black Widow only came out for us a few days ago. PC's had it for over a week. We've had it for 4 days. This is actually the 5th day that it's been out. So, yeah. She's not exactly fit to boot. At one point there was a glitch with this one where he would literally stay up there, you could be down here just shooting at him. They fixed that a while ago. He could not move, he would not fight, and it was a very easy fight because, well, nobody took any damage. Hello Mirri. But yes, with this guy, he has this, like, you don't even get a notice when he's about to do the mechanic, but he will jump in the air and, like, within that of an instant, he'll bring his weapon down and it will send you flying, basically. But yeah, that's,
I can't allow you to muck about in here.
You can knock him off his thing. You got to go back. That one there. Basically split second everything. I've been able to do it once my entire time doing this game. And this dungeon. Yeah, when the tanks don't really do their job. There we go. I dodged it again. Because I knew That move is also for banish spells. You know, with the last boss doing that. Oh, I'm definitely here. There we go. No. Okay, not all. I need him to have a healing with Mirri alone. Not the cracker, yes, he will. Come on. Thing. Not much of stamina. Over there is some traps. Around the corner will be some Steavers. You know, the thing that everyone loves. Especially in this dungeon. Just attack my girl. Also, their health regen is so bad. Like, they will only heal after a battle or when their ability allows them to heal. Who am I? Because he's never been beaten in combat. Okay. So let's kill these mud crabs. Maybe they'll give us some chicken. Which is an alchemy ingredient. Or, you know, they're just gonna give us some XP. It's fine. There's now gonna be some skeevers over here. So if you noticed prior to that fight, this area was closed off. Here.
Ooh, that was a bit of a long
yeah,
map.
He's not an optional boss, you see. In order to progress, you need to kill him to unlock this. Mirri, do you mind standing like you're a guard of this place? Because you're not. So, this one, Sawbones, are the healers. So whatever you do, get those out of the way. Also, necromancers, they are up on the back side. Enderman in one of the dungeons, I think it's they are looking at the back sides. But if anything, you do those working in the back side. So get those gone first. More fishing holes here, by the way. Right, so now we're gonna get the attention of these skeevers. Try not to get the attention of the humanoids over there until we've got these skeevers gone. Okay, now have a look at what you've got. So about 5-6 people. Okay, 5 of them. Yeah, and then of course, those in the tunnel, as soon as we've got these gone, we're all going to get it. So there's your healer.
Let your magicka recover.
Of course, she's telling me to let my magicka recover. So there's 3 of those, 3 people in the thing. Right now you can only see 2. That's because one of them walks throughout the tunnel. Let's see, that person is now going on. You know. Right, here are some more. So we are now over here. Basically where the fight has just taken place with that guy. Yeah. Basically we're now up here. And then we've got here, and then this is where the last boss is going to take place. Okay. As you can see, there is a sawbone to the left. I'm not going to be Skeever's attention just yet. Oops, I say that, and one of the Skeevers has spotted me, but he's not going anywhere. Noticed me, but he was not doing anything because I hadn't attacked him yet or gotten too close. But hey. So, even more. As you can kind of see, there's a sawbone right there. Looking. You catch my drift? Okay, so in here we've got a healer, we've got a cutthroat, and we've got a necromancer. So, again, get rid of the healer first. And then we work with the necromancer. And then Mr. Jumpy Pants over here. On Mr. Jumpy Pants because he's just tried jumping over me and look what it cost him. His life. So, right now, these losers are gone. Yes, guys, I know I need one skill. I noticed that you have a damage shield. Yep. I always forget to use it. Come on. Don't fault me. So, these guys. People forget that they're there. And, you know, sometimes I do too. With this, oh, and look, there's a chest over there too, in this blue lily colour. So we shall get that too. I actually don't know where all the chests fit in here. I know where the one after the last boss is. But between the beginning and the end, I have no clue. Mirri, are you about to say that I'm buying drinks? Cause yep, yeah, I will be. Okay, so now I'm going to run all the way back up. Just to make sure that I don't miss out on these. And yes, guys, this place is the sewers. It looks a lot like Imperial City sewers, but it's not. Okay, you've also got a thing. Everything is basically attached to the sewers in Imperial City. I was there the other day, not just in this game. I was in day prior to Blackwood coming out, I was going to install it. Well, it was already installed, but I decided that I was going to actually play it after getting my book in the store. No, guys, unless I really feel like it when I edit this, that clip will not be added. And now that I've mentioned it, you guys are going to want that clip.
Pain ain't the word, but
what's left in the fine. Probably put it as a bonus clip at the end for all of you who wish to see it. After my outro. Yay!
Circle around.
Of course they're going to be after Mirri. Leave her alone. I the last boss over here. So, oh. The plan was just then to maybe not get the thing attached to me until I got some time to attack. But I'm in front. I believe there is a chest that can sometimes spawn within that boat there that you can see when you stood on. There is an enemy here. Stuck in the wall. Yay! That's always fun. Another little glitch that's in the game. When your enemies get stuck in a wall. Okay, so before I continue, let's make sure that everything is charged up, repaired, because this fight is gonna need it. Okay, so. Plus, the more powerful your weapon, the higher your damage output can be, or so I heard. If I get that wrong, please let me know. I would hate to have some false information on anything and not take my word on anything that I say. Okay? Please. I just want to know who the hell that person is that you're freaking saying. Right, so. The boss is there. What we're gonna do is deal with these guys. Roll dodging. Yeah. Well, I do. Don't do that, though, people. Don't do that. Put something down. What I want to find is to get that sawbow from over here without grabbing the boss. So if I want to take the boss, the main boss, before I, you know, attack her, before she attacks me, she's coming away from her first. You can see I'm going to be careful with where I aim. So, yep, she's just used fear on them. So. This boss here. Aline, whatever her name is. Every 25% of health, she will vanish and give you some hallucinations of bats, which you have to kill in order for her to come back. When she comes back, she will try and stab you in the back, which can do a lot of damage. When I know that's coming, I do this and I try and, you know, circle around because I don't know where she's going to be. But that's every 25% of her health gone. She will do it at 75, 50 and 25% of health. After the 25% of health, she will become enraged, which will be like this black figure with the red glowing eyes. And that's when most of her movements, they get faster, they're more powerful and damaging. Just burn her, okay? Just burn her, okay? So let's get this. Also, there's another fishing hole there for all of you little fishies, fishermen and men and women. But yeah, Mirri, are you ready to get this done? Because I definitely am. So I shall start this off by mage gilding her. That move there, she was just used back. Try and get out of most of her moves, because if she gets you down, she will. Thank you. in a full group.
They're coming for us.
Okay. This combat is fun. But the solo runs with Mirri. These are only on normal. Because otherwise we would be in hours getting our butt swept, running out of soul gems, you know, all of that. Teleporting back to the shrines in here. Trying to armor me. And obviously, she says, don't go find your mommy. That's American. Yeah, if they wanted to try and not have it where, you know, mum, mummy, ma'am, wouldn't you think that maybe they should have kept it to mother and father? You know, I live in the northeast of England, and up here it's mammy. And ma'am. Everywhere else it's mom and mummy. And then in America, it's mommy and mom. Of course, I was one of those weird kids, but I've been reading American books and watching a lot of American TV shows. I developed an American accent as a teen, and it bothered my mother and my siblings. They were calling her mom, and I was calling her mom. And I'm like, well, yes, no. I'm like, really? So she's about to do her last thing with the bats, and as soon as she comes back, she's going to be in her rage state. Mirri is doing pretty well here. As you can kind of see, it started off with a little amount, so let's, okay. As you can see, in rage, she's going to be a lot quicker with her movements, more powerful. No. There's the famous tablet spiller coming in to ask if anyone wants anything. Some alcohol would be nice, Dad. Some alcohol. Okay. So, I see he's trying to hit very hard. Okay, there's a new move, but everything is basically taking a lot of my health then, but she's dead. Okay. And we've got some more stuff for our booklet. And over here, we have our chest that I told you about just now. You know, at the end there is a chest. It's random whether or not you will get it or not.
Looks like you're buying at the next
and
pub,
you can find one here. You know? But as I said, it is all random. Okay. So there is your Wayrest Sewers 1. I believe there could be some stuff here. But for that, you would have to check it yourself. For me, there is not. Otherwise, it is Wayrest Sewers 2 that I'm thinking of, that there is enemies over there. So guys, as you saw, I died. We died. It was a fun dungeon. I don't die in dungeons, but that one boss, it had me. Maybe because I don't know the mechanics off by heart. Because everyone skips it. But as I said, after this bit, there will be the bonus clip of me dying in Oblivion. The first time I ever played Oblivion. So yeah. I'll say it right now. Stay safe. Stay soul-shriven. And peace out.
You also dead. Oh shit, there's now two goblins. Ah, one of them has a bow!